This video is an introduction to the foreign exchange market. Every day, euros are being exchanged for dollars, dollars for yens, and yens for euros. This represents part of the exchanges done on a market called foreign exchange market. But how is this market organized? How are exchange rates between the different currencies set? This is a foreign exchange market explained in plain English by Fabienne Deville. John and Mary are going to spend the weekend in London. They estimate the amount of their expenses at 300 euros. As Great Britain is not part of the eurozone, they have to buy British pounds. They go to the bank to exchange 300 euros for British pounds. At the time of the transaction, 1 euro is 0.8661 pounds. John and Mary will get £259.83 for their 300 euros, amount free of brokerage fees. This buy-sale transaction took place on the foreign exchange market. Behind this transaction, there is Peter. Peter works at Scrooge Bank as a trader. Every day, he gets British pound buying requests and euro buying requests. As for all goods, price, here the exchange rate of a currency, is set by supply and demand. If the request of English pounds goes up against euros, an imbalance is created and the British pound's exchange rate increases. The British pound will get stronger compared to the euro. Watch out! Tourists are not the only actors on the foreign exchange market. Goods and services companies, states, investors, and even speculators act on the forex. The supply and demand law is not the only item affecting a currency rate. Other items also take place to work out currency rates. Current interest rates, the political situation of countries, economic indicators such as the gross domestic product, inflation rate, etc. Be careful, this is only true in a floating rate system, a notion to be discovered further in this course. To summarize, the foreign exchange market is made up by the set of buy-sales and loan-borrow transactions in currencies.